So here now with more, Congressman Trey Gowdy, the chair of the House Oversight Committee. Good to see you tonight, Congressman. Welcome.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
So with regard to oversight and your role, and there's already discussions about wanting to talk to Donald Trump Jr. about this meeting on the Hill, is it illegal to speak to a foreign national who you believe is going to turn over opposition research on a candidate?
I haven't been a real lawyer in 7 years, Martha, so I'm not sure I'm qualified to answer the legality of it. The good news for us is we have a guy named Robert Mueller, who's a former United States attorney and the head of the FBI. And if you look at the document that empowers him with jurisdiction, the very first entry links coordination between the Russian government and members of the Trump campaign. So I'm going to let Bob Mueller sort out all the criminality. That is not the job of members of Congress, and it's not the job of the New York Times.
All right. So in terms of this this Donald Jr. story that's out there today, are you troubled by any of it?
Yeah, I'm troubled on three levels. Number one, the legal level, but I think that's Bob Mueller's lane. The political level, Martha, here we are beginning another week, this one in July, with a new revelation about Russia. And then the third, which is more of a medical issue, is the amnesia of people that are in the Trump orbit. Someone close to the president needs to get everyone connected with that campaign in a room and say, from the time you saw Dr. Zhivago until the moment you drank vodka with a guy named Boris, you list every single one of those, and we're going to turn them over to the special counsel, because this drip, drip, drip is undermining the credibility of this administration.
Well, you may be right about that. In terms of this Magnitsky Act, which basically is a U.S. act that went through Congress that limits friends of Vladimir Putin, close associates, from doing things they like to do, like traveling to the United States, traveling, you know, throughout other areas in the world, because it's, you know, it's a slap on the wrist for human rights violations, and it's selective in terms of who it impacts. It also, so their punishment, the Russian government's punishment, was to say, we're going to end all of these adoptions that are happening to the United States and a few other things that they did. Are you concerned that there was an effort to influence this campaign with regard to changing that, or to find sort of sympathetic ear on that?
I'm not nearly as concerned with that. I've had members of my own church impacted by the inability to adopt children from Russia. I'm much more concerned about the purported reason for the meeting as opposed to the real reason. The purported reason was for an agent of a foreign power to try to influence our election. That concerns me more than someone trying to sit down with a member of perhaps an incoming administration to lobby for a policy change. I'm much more concerned with the actual words in the email than the real reason she wanted to meet.
Which words in the email disturb you?
Russian government's efforts to help the Trump campaign, official documents. Those are the kind of words that for months and months Republicans have been saying. There is no evidence of collusion between Trump, the Trump campaign, or even hangers-on. And here we have this meeting that may amount to nothing, but here we are on a Tuesday, on a week we ought to be discussing infrastructure tax reform, and we're still talking about Russia, and frankly, with some good reason, because this email, we should have known about it before yesterday.
All right, we're going to talk more about that in a moment, but you know, in terms of the other story, Jim Comey and the leaking of supposedly some classified information when he took those notes after his meeting with the president. Is that, do those notes become a government document, and do you want to hear more from him on this?
I do. You mentioned oversight. I'm also on House Intel. I'm also on Judiciary. Those two committees are probably the more appropriate committees to have a conversation with Director Comey. The memos are available. The FBI has made them available, and I am going to look at them this week. I do not want to prejudge. I don't think it's fair to do it to Republicans. I don't think it's fair to do it to Comey to think that because someone reported something, it's necessarily true. I don't know whether there's classified information in these memos or not. I'm going to read them this week. I'll have a better idea. That's probably going to be a House Intel issue as opposed to oversight.
All right. We look forward to hearing more from you on that as you move forward with it. Congressman Trey Gowdy, always a pleasure. Thank you very much.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
So we are going to have more in just a moment from Sean Hannity's exclusive.